Welcome to Roosevelt High School. This is Friday night high school rugby in Fresno, California. I'm Barry Foley. I'm here with Paul Carter. And we are about ready to kick off with, looks like Fresno High versus Clovis West is going to be kicking off here. Paul, what do you think?
I think it's going to be a great night for rugby. It's nice and cool. It's a beautiful evening. The pitch looks nice and green. And I think you're right. We're going to have a good night of rugby.
We are. This is a great facility. They've redone it out here recently. The grass is perfect for rugby. The field's a little bit short for regulation, but we're good with that. These players got a lot of energy, a lot of excitement going on right now. This is a big battle between two teams that are about the same level, I'd say, in play. Maybe Fresno High has been a little bit more experienced than Clovis West. They've had a bit of a tough year this last year, but hey, they got some great new coaches, and it's coming along good.
No, absolutely. I think both these rugby clubs are known for their physical play. It'll be interesting to see how this thing pairs out for each team.
You bet. We've got Zane Jury refereeing this game. Zane is still plays a little bit of rugby with the Fresno Rugby Club. He has been reffing for a couple years now and then helping out with the high school programs here. So we're very fortunate to have Zane. I'm sorry. His dad is named Jeff. Well,
yeah, that's right. I know where that thing comes from. Huh? Yeah. Jeff Jury?
You bet. You
started
bet.
Playing 1974, I think Zane was telling us before the broadcast.
That's why we call him the old beer wolf.
So. That's right. Yeah. Are we supposed to say that? This high school rugby,
that's right.
We can still say it.
Yeah, he's not
out
here.
There for all you rugby fans out there.
We keep it clean.
Yeah,
here.
He was a great, a lot of people don't know that, Jeff had a piece in local youth rugby through intermediate schools for a long time, and he was, probably one of the first guys in our area to really try to push that, and it took a little time, but here we are.
Yeah, he did. He had his two boys, and that's what got him started doing them when they were in elementary school back there at Eaton Elementary in North Fresno, and they've grown up playing a little bit of rugby, so we're just about ready. He's talking to the Clovis West, and we'll be underway shortly, so.
Get his attention.
Okay, so I think we just gave him the cue, and I think Zane's just getting ready to get these guys to kick off. We're going to be ready to rock and roll here.
Here we go.
Some Friday night rugby, ladies and gentlemen.
So in rugby here, we've got Clovis West is going to kick off. The ball's got to travel 10 meters on the kickoff, and we're off. We're underway. Here we go.
And there it goes. Well, it's nicely handled. Well, that's a big young man right there, huh?
That is a
big
guy.
And Fresno High setting up a nice ruck. They recycled the ball well.
Nice tackle there by Clovis West. Hold him up. Yep, we've got a ruck here. Ball still on the ground.
Yeah, and Fresno High needs to be a little more patient there on their runner plays off the backside of that ruck there.
Yeah, and Clovis West stepped offside there, so we've got an advantage going towards Fresno High right now. And the whistle has blown, so now we've got a penalty against Clovis West. They'll retreat 10 meters from the place of the mark. The referee will indicate the where the penalty was taken at, and this Fresno High has chosen to kick for touch, which they have successfully
done. Which
was
a beautiful kick there, wasn't that, Barry?
That was a great kick. Yeah. He got a lot of yardage. It will be Fresno High's ball with a throw-in now in rugby. When the ball travels outside the boundaries of play, either on the sidelines or sometimes through the back of the end zone, it's restarted with a line-out where the team that has possession of the ball will choose how many players, up to seven, can be in the lineout, and the other team must match them or cannot have more. They can have less, but they cannot have more.
Oh, nice steal by Clovis West there.
You bet that was.
And I thought it was a decent throw by Fresno High, so even nicer that Clovis West was able to get a piece of that.
Yeah, it did. It went right down the tunnel. That's what you're supposed to do, and now we've got Fresno High.
Nice little pick and drive there off the ruck. I'm surprised the ref didn't call him for not releasing the ball there.
Yeah, it looked like he was tackled there, but the referee in rugby makes every call. He doesn't have anybody help from the sidelines at this level, and
Fresno High's really attacking.
Yeah, they are. They're close here. Pushing hard. Let's see what happens. The referee's in a good spot. He can see what's going on. And he dives across. Not yet. No try given yet.
So there looks like, was that a penalty of some sort?
Yeah, I'm not sure if it's a penalty or a try. I'm not sure which he's given. Let's see what happens here.
Looks like it was a penalty against Fresno High. Missed opportunity there, so Clovis West will get possession. And in rugby, in a penalty, the team that is penalized has to retreat 10 meters.
No, he's signaled he's giving him a try.
Yeah,
so, yep. So a little hard to see the signal there. Should be a straight up and down arm signal, but, you know, we figured it out from here. So now it's his Fresno High will have the opportunity to kick at goal or after the try. That try is worth 5 points in rugby. The conversion kick afterwards is worth 2 if he makes it. So, and the kick is taken directly in line from where the ball was touched down in the try zone. So we've got number 22 here from Fresno High making the kick, which we'll see how he does here.
Well, it's a little windy night. Let's see how he strikes this ball. That's well struck, but it looks like it's going to be a little wide
to
the right.
Far right. So we've got Fresno High leading by 5.
So a little terminology, the term touchdown, a lot of people may or may not know this fact, but the term touchdown in American football, gridiron, comes from the downward pressure that needs to be applied to score a try in rugby in the try zone. The ball has to be touched down, and that's where the term comes from.
Yeah, exactly. Some
and obviously, I need to take a trip to the eye doctor after this because I didn't see that from this angle.
Yeah, no, it's...
But it was an obvious try by Fresno High.
Yeah, another kickoff here now. In rugby, if the team that scores they receive the ball in a kickoff instead of kicking off. So now Clovis West was scored again, so they've kicked off again. Kicked off to Fresno High. Fresno High's making a run
here. Oh, nice dummy.
Nice dummy, yeah. He's going to reset the ball. Tackled there. Ball's out quickly. Out to the wing, still running here. Rugby, the ball is live as he's tackled. The idea is to keep possession and keep the ball on your side. It's tough to see right here.
Fresno High seems to be doing a good job of recycling the ball on the breakdowns, or what's called a ruck in rugby.
Got their big guy running hard there, number 8. He's the 8 man.
Very nice set.
He's got to release that ball, though, a little slow.
Well, you mentioned something about the size of the pitch before we started this match, and we're playing on a field that's more accustomed for football, and you can tell it's small for rugby, and it seems to be a little bit of an issue. It's very narrow.
Yeah, unfortunately, it's a little narrow. Could have been a little wider, but for safety reasons, there's some concrete on the side here. They've made it the width that it is, and lengthwise, it could be a little longer, but again, it's just up to the setting up the field. I think they had a little miscommunication, but you know what? These kids have a lot of energy. They'll run as hard as they can on whatever size field.
Yeah, and it's really nice to see this being played out here at Roosevelt High School.
And we've still got Fresno High maintaining possession. Referee blew a whistle there.
It looked like the 8 man went to go pick the ball out of the ruck, and he knocked it on in the process.
Knocked it on.
We really teach our kids to try to bend their knees and shorten the distance from the ground, from their chest to the ground, by getting good and low. And you can see there the 8 man went to go pick the ball on the backside of the ruck, and he was a little straight up and down, and he just basically fumbled the ball a little bit.
So we've got rugby,
you can't do that.
So we've got a restart on a scrum. Many people are aware of the term scrum. This is a scrum in rugby. 16 players here putting the ball together. The ball was put in by Clovis West. Referee blew the whistle. It looked like the scrum kind of collapsed there. To avoid dangerous play, the referee will stop it, and they will restart the scrum here.
A little bit of a break for Clovis West. It looked like Fresno High was driving home, or could have very well stole that put in by Clovis West.
Fresno High's got to stay down low, though. He came up high there. He's got to stay down low. See how they do here. Ball's put in. It's gone back to Clovis West this time. Picked up by the 8 man. Good run there.
Nice little pickup by the 8 man there.
Yeah. Tackled by the 8 on the other team by Fresno High.
Yeah, good recycle. Nice little pick and drive again by Clovis West.
Yep, they're doing good. Hang on to that ball, Clovis West.
Let's see if they can get some continuity in the back line.
Little missed pass there, but he picked it up. Good run. Still in possession. Again, they're tackled repeatedly. Ball stays on Clovis West side. That means they maintain possession as long as they don't knock it forward or give it up and let Fresno High get it. So always put back. There it is. The ball is placed back towards Clovis West side, and they're running hard again.
And I think Clovis West is maybe leaving some opportunities on the table here. I can see some of those backs are just, we got a nice little squeeze out right out of the outside of that ruck there, but just not doing a good job of getting the ball out to the rest of the backs.
Yeah, and I think this is where we're seeing the narrow field kind of tends to cut that down, and unfortunately, but here we want to do some straight ahead running, and this is where you'll gain some ground if you stay straight run forward and run straight. But
great contact at the ruck there.
Yeah. See the number 8 for Fresno High is a very aggressive player. Good tackling technique and a big size
guy. Nice
there.
Counter ruck being done right here, but looks like Fresno High is going to get called for diving over.
No, hands in the ruck there. Penalty against Clovis West.
That's interesting.
Yep, it'll be kicked for touch here. Looks like they're going to call for touch. So, yeah, Clovis West, I saw a player put his hand on the ball while it was in the ruck there, which is a penalty, and thus Fresno High was allowed to kick here. So it'll be a line out again to Fresno High. Again, the ball must travel at least 5 meters to that first white line that you'll see there. And then there's a distance of 10 more meters in between that where the ball has to land between 5 and 15 meters from the sideline. And that's where the players are waiting for the ball, but it has to go straight down the tunnel as well. So the defending team, Clovis West, can jump and try to get the ball. And this is a wind like this, sometimes it happens where they'll get it. So Fresno High maintains possession, it looks like.
And there's the ball right there.
Yeah.
And looks like Clovis West got away with a little bit of an offsides there on the ruck, but worked out for Fresno High still. And they're battling up the pitch.
Yeah, there they go. They're maintaining possession. Fresno High still got it. He's put it back for his team. Picked up and run by that big number 8 again.
Yeah, really like
he's
that young man.
There. He's still on his feet.
And he's scrapping
driving
pretty hard.
That's Jonah Maldonado for Fresno High, the number 8. Good runner there. Fresno High still got the ball. Going for the corner, looks like. Hard to say. Oh.
Looks like it's going to be a penalty against Clovis West here.
Yeah. This is a what they call a short arm penalty. So it's an indirect kick. We'll see what they do here. Yeah. Again, they give it to their big number 8. Drives pretty hard there.
Let's get a little white line fever. Let's see if he can recycle this ball out.
They are. They're close.
Seem to be a little high. Looks like they got some numbers here on the outside to their back line if they can get that ball out.
Definitely,
but
they got their fullback in there. Looks like another penalty. Tap down. Gave it to, I can't tell. Let's see. Did
yeah,
it
looks
it
like
to?
A try is awarded.
Yeah, another try. Fresno High try. Number 2, 10-0 right now is the score. Diving over there. He took a quick tap and dove over the try line. That's what he needed to do. So Clovis West will retreat here. They got to be behind the try line. During the kick, they can charge the kick once the player moves towards the ball. Sometimes that helps kind of make him think about the kick a little bit, but looks like they're just going to get some water and regroup, have a little talk from one of their coaches.
So for those of you who are watching this game at home, what you can't see is that the kicker's kicking directly into a pretty good headwind right now. Let's see if this young man can get a good strike on the ball. It's a little tough condition to be kicking into. It looks like his coach is gonna kind of hold the ball up a little bit. That's how tough the wind is right now. He gets 1 minute to kick the ball.
I didn't see who scored that try for Fresno High. Let's see how he does here.
And it's a well-struck ball. Nope. Looks like it just sailed wide to the left.
Yep, so that leaves it at 10-0. Fresno High, we're just in about 11 minutes of rugby played. We've got 24 to go. And again, Clovis West will be kicking off to Fresno High. Fresno High scored, so they will receive the ball again on the kickoff. Looks like we're missing a 10-meter line this time, but
well, let's see some of these big fellas from Clovis West can get up underneath that ball. That ball's live for everybody.
It's a nice kick.
In that situation, looks like it's just going to go bounce out.
So look out of bounds. It'll be a line out to Fresno High over there where it crossed the touch line. So again, the referee is the single. We do have touch judges. We should have one. I don't know if I see one on that far side, but touch judges are usually volunteers at this level, sometimes players, and they just help the referee mark the line as it wherever the ball might cross, if the player steps out of bounds or the ball crosses the touch line. The touch line is the sideline in rugby. The try line is the goal line, if you will. Good steal there by Clovis West on
Clovis
that lineup.
Clovis West is doing a pretty good job of stealing the balls. I don't know if the wind's giving him a little bit of trouble, but It just goes to show that it looks a little tougher than it really is.
You can tell these ClovisWest kids are well coached. I know they've started out with a rough season, missing some players, didn't have a few coaches this year, but Neil Grossman and a couple other people have stepped up in the last month or two and have really helped a lot bringing them along. They don't have a lot of size, but boy, look at the, they're in the right spot. They're ready to go. And they're gaining ground on Fresno High right now. So let's see what happens
here. They're recycling the ball well, but they just haven't, both teams really have had a hard time getting any backline play. And I think at this point it'd be good to shake things up a little bit and get the ball out to the backline.
Yeah, let them run a little bit, see if they can get past them. Now we're spreading it out, going to the left of the field here a little bit. Still got it, though. ClovisWest is controlling the ball. They're doing well. That's what rugby's all about, stay in possession.
And ClovisWest, unfortunate deal, lost the ball there.
Little kick
nice
ahead.
Little pooch kick.
Good catch by ClovisWest fullback.
And he's going to try to counterattack.
Yeah, he's got to set that ball,
release it. Let's see if ClovisWest a little slow to get back in support. Nice heady run by number 18. And now the ball's out
to
the back line.
To the backs a little bit, you got to make that pass. But they're still maintaining possession, so that's what they need to do. Just got to keep going forward. Oh, he lost it there. Lost it backwards. They're still driving, though. ClovisWest is still battling. Going forward. Well done. Keeping possession. That's what they need to do. Fresno High's patiently waiting for them, making some good tackles here. Again, there's no number, no limit of plays you can do in rugby. It just keeps going. Looks like it was knocked forward there by.
Oh, that's a miss. Missed West. Opportunity. ClovisWest. Their forward play has been pretty darn good so far. I mean, they're picking and driving the ball, getting short meters here and there, but they seem to be driving the ball. It's been tough for them to turn that ball over like that. And the other thing is, I'd love to see them recycle the ball out to the backs a little more.
Yeah, and that's gonna wear those forwards down playing that type of game they're playing. It's great rugby, but it's hard. It's tiring. And again, like I was saying, there is no number of minimum or maximum number of times you can do that. They can do that for 10, 15, 20 minutes if they're up to it, but it's a lot of work.
So nice. Here's a successful line out by Fresno High.
Nice throw, and you can see that was right down the line. That was
like they're just
going
to try to maul this ball forward. Yep. Now they're going to recycle it back out.
Yep, good play there. All the way out to their
fly
half.
Boy, that young fly half missed an opportunity because he had backs open in a good depth attacking position. He should have passed the ball out. They're able to maintain possession of the ball, but it's still a lost opportunity.
Yeah.
Boy, I love this eight man, this kid here.
Jonah.
Jonah's just doing a heck of a job. He runs very hard.
Yeah.
That a boy.
Good set there. Ball's getting recycled. Here we go again.
Here we go to a nice runner play to their hooker.
That was a great play. Saw the runner coming.
He's a stout young man.
He had some speed coming across the line there. That's what you want. The rest of the team, they're ready. They're lined up. Ready to go, big number five there. Look at him. He said, give me the ball, give me the ball. I'm ready to go. They're out to the backs here. Let's see if we can score.
Nice.
That's Marquise. That was Marquise that
got tackled there.
Got tackled.
Looks like the wing is trying to pick and drive again. Let's see if they can keep this ball alive. Oh,
looks
unfortunately.
Like he knocked it. Yeah, Clovis Fresno High knocked it forward there. Ball's out of touch. And it looks like it's going to go.
There was an advantage. It looked like on the first knock on before it went out of bounds.
Yeah, the referee caught that, knocked it on
first. Looks like it's going to be a scrum down to ClovisWest.
Yep, you're right. So good call there by the referee. We saw that. I think everybody saw that. Here we go. Scrum here. ClovisWest put the ball in. See if they can get out of their. They're back about their own 10, 15 meter line from the goal line. So let's see if they can make some. Make some yardage here and get out of here. Maybe a little kick might be a deep kick would be a good play right now, but we'll see what they want to do. Here we go.
And looks like good job. Oh, nice pressure off from the scrum half.
There we go.
ClovisWest got him a nice little pooch kick.
Nice kick there down to
That's where a kick really helps you out, right?
That was right there. Look, he made about on this field that's probably about 40 meters.
Yeah,
but that was a good effort. What that did that. Took them out of danger a little bit.
Absolutely.
It did give the ball over to Fresno High, but you know what? That's they'd much rather have it down there than where they were. So.
Well, they're 10 meters from the opposing team's try zone, and and they're trying to defend 10 meters of turf, and now they're in a much better position here, field-wise, possession-wise.
So Fresno High line out again here. You can see the go straight down the tunnel. Let's see what happens. Nice throw over the top a little bit. Picked up by the number 8 man again. Jonah, big hit
that
there.
That was a huge hit. He really brought the wood with that hit, Barry.
Yeah, ran over that Clovis West player. Nice run again, number 6.
And unfortunately, he's going to knock the ball forward.
Knock on whistle.
You know, we tell our kids all the time, possession is everything. All that for nothing. It's a tough break. Got to really protect that ball, though.
Yeah, definitely. You know, just going back to the series that Clovis West had, you know, they probably had 10 different, you know, runs in there, gained a little bit of ground. But one long run like that, like Fresno High, and they knocked it on. So they lost the ball. Now it's back to Clovis West, ball in a scrum here. So scrum, Clovis West put in at a scrum just a little bit off the halfway mark.
Looks like Clovis West is going to a nice little steal by the scrum half. There, who's just been pester, just been totally attacking the opposing scrum half from Clovis West.
Yeah, that ball, once it crosses the last foot of that number 8 or comes out of that scrum, that ball is anybody's ball. It's live ball again. Big run again by number 8 there, Jonah. Good recycling of the ball. Comes back out, number 20 there, the guy that knocked it on a minute ago. Looks like he knocked it on again. So two knock-ons in a row.
So he's just holding that ball kind of haphazard, like it's a loaf of bread. He just got off his Kinch's seek.
Yeah.
And Clovis West is stealing it from him. Yeah. And it's hurting his team.
No, quick tap and go. Try to have a quick tap and go with Clovis West there, which it wasn't a penalty. That's why the referee called it back. It's a scrum, so he does have to restart in a scrum. He can't tap and go on that. Only in a penalty can he do that. So it'd be Clovis West put in again. A little bit deep in their territory. Let's see if they go for the same option of looking, trying to kick out of trouble here. Fresno High won that scrum, pushed over the Clovis West players. Nice run by Marquise there.
Probably should have made that offload.
Yeah,
he's got to trust that. I know it's a short field, but you know, he can always retreat a little bit and become an option for a pass back into him.
Yep. Made a good run there, but
he had a wing open with no man on that numerical advantage, even though it was a tight space.
There's a try by Fresno High. Number, what, I didn't see his number. I think that was the player that kept knocking it on before. Is that number 22?
Yeah.
Is that him again?
So I love the way that kid runs.
Little redemption there.
Yes.
Number 20, a little redemption, scored the try to make up for those two knock-ons. So we've got 15-0 in favor of Fresno High right now, with 15 minutes to go in the half, so we're a little more than halfway through this first half. We've got the kicker coming out, number 22 again, to try to make that that conversion kick. So
I think number 20, if we're reading this roster properly, is Alberto Reyes.
That was our try scorer, I think so.
And I agree with you, Barry. Got a little redemption.
Yeah,
great. He runs hard.
That's how you do on the kick here. Looks like the wind's dying down. I don't see much wind right now. A little bit, but not too bad.
We'll see if he gets a little break from Mother Nature right now.
Well, there we go.
Ball.
There's our
looks
first
like
conversion
right
of the night. Yeah, there we go.
Nice kick.
Well, that's two more points. So that makes the score 17-0 in favor of Fresno High. With 14 and a half minutes to go in the match, or the first half, again, Clovis West will be kicking off to Fresno High here. At halftime, they'll switch sides. Referee waiting for the Clovis West kids to get up here, kick off. Again, it's a beautiful night here in Fresno. Looks like their rain is not coming, a little windy, but nice temperature and looking good out here tonight. Great surface. This field is a perfect field for rugby. Nice natural grass.
So just over 13 minutes official time here, and it looks like this has been a battle of the forwards so far, Barry.
Yeah, definitely. Nice deep kickoff there by Clovis West, all the way back to the try line. It was a great kick. Little kick ahead by Fresno High. Handled nicely by the wing on Clovis West. Good run. Nice up the sideline run.
If he had the presence of mind, he could have counterattacked towards us.
Yeah.
It looked like he had some players like set up.
Ball was stolen there in the tackle. Fresno High's got the ball now. Here he comes. Making a quick run out to the side. Nice pass out. A little mishandled.
Unfortunate.
Still Fresno High ball. Ball went backwards, so there's no reason to call. Referee's letting things play here. Good tackling by Clovis West. Here we got another run out here. Number 20.
There's our.
That was Alberto.
There's a. Yeah.
Alberto Reyes with another good run. And the whistle blown by the referee. It was like a penalty against Clovis West for hands in the ruck.
Actually, it looked like Barry was somebody just kind of lost their feet and fell over the ruck.
Okay. We've got the referee making the signal. Now the reverse penalty against.
For a shepherd.
Yeah, against Fresno High for obstruction or shepherding, as we sometimes say.
A little sloppy play,
say,
it looks like, by both teams.
That just
and
means
that's unfortunate. Fresno High, you know, you can't, in rugby, there's no blocking. Whether you intended to or not, you can't run behind one of your players, and they'll call you for that every time, as they should.
Yeah, a little
anything
tap
that impedes positive forward movement in rugby is a penalty.
Yeah, we had a penalty run there by the Clovis West player. Good hard run, good tackling though, still maintaining possession. Here's one of their big guys for Clovis West setting the ball. Number 6 from Fresno High has got to get out of the way there. He's trying, there he is. Ball came straight out. I think the referee's going to stop it there. Call penalty against Fresno High. That player did not get out of the way quick enough. Little quick tap and go for number 10 there for Clovis West, where again, the referee stopping the play. Penalty against Fresno High for
not being back 10,
not
it looks
retreating.
Like,
yep, they got to retreat 10 meters when there's a penalty. They did not get back far enough, so now they'll kick. I'm sorry, now they will restart from here. Looks like we got a little timeout. Maybe we got an injured player down on the ground, so we'll take a second here and see how he's doing. But in rugby, there's no timeouts, so we don't stop for a timeout. If there is an injury, the referee will give you time to assess him and look at him, and looks like it's nothing too serious, so they will play on, looks like. So the referee's telling him to get going. They've got a penalty play. Player taps the ball. Hard run forward by number 5. Good run. Resets the ball. We're ready to go. Here we go again. Another good. This is good running by Clovis West here. Looking good.
Well, I've been impressed with the physicality of both teams in this game. Tackling's been good. Running's been good and hard.
Another penalty against Fresno High. Looks like for diving over, killing the ball.
I wouldn't be surprised if, no advantage. I don't see advantage. But
yeah, we're going. It looked like it knocked it on there. Not sure. We saw a bobble.
I think he was able to maintain it.
That's great. Looks like he's got it. They're still going.
Clovis West is attacking effectively.
They are. Get that ball back. There they are. Let's see what happens here. They're within about 5 meters or 4 meters. Good run by the big guy. Did he get it down? They're still moving. There it is. Hard to tell. Looking for the signal from the referee. Playing on.
Very, very
close.
This
is rugby. This is good rugby here. The ball just keeps going. Keep going after it and keep going after it. They're going to try to hold him up. He's across the try.
And
there's a try by Clovis West.
Very, very good.
Who is that number? Let's see. We'll get his name and number for you here in a second. Good effort by Clovis West all around. They maintained great possession. Couple penalties there to their advantage. Quick taps and go. And we've got a great game going on
here. Was that their hooker, number 3?
Number 1 looks like one of their props. Let's see who we got here. That is Alexander Burnaby.
Well, it was an excellent pick
great
and drive.
Job. So we're looking at 17-5.
He was obviously determined when he crossed the try zone. When he picked that ball up, his shoulders were low, his chest was low to the ground, and he was determined to get that ball over the try zone line.
Yeah, being a back most of my rugby career, I hated having forwards come at me like that. So I know what those guys are like. It's no fun getting low to tackle.
There's
those
a little
guys.
Pepper in that lane, huh?
Yeah,
little
you
pepper
betcha.
In that lane. Well, you know, we teach our kids to get low, tackle right, keep your head out of the way.
Unfortunate extra kick there by the fly half for Clovis West. Missed that kick, but we're 17-5 with about 9 minutes to go in the game. The match, the first half. Sorry about that. But so here we have Fresno High having to kick off now to Clovis West after they scored. So this is what we'd like to see. Good back and forth rugby here.
Clovis West got a little thing going here, and Fresno High kind of fell apart a little bit there with penalties.
Yeah, you bet.
Got to be disciplined.
Yep, so momentum for Clovis West here. They're going to get the ball and then hopefully maintain possession. There we go, the drop kick. He's got it. Here we go forward. Hooker number 2 for Clovis West there is Darian Bishop. Good run. Scrum half gets it out. to the fly half. You know, again, the fly half, they are not usually the biggest guys in the field, but boy, they are usually one of the shiftiest, and he's a shifty fly half. He's hard to bring down, it looks like, and he's been very successful out there. So we got the big guy again here. Good run. Nice run.
I like the way this young man runs for his size as well.
That was nice. Set it up.
Clovis West is going to, well, they're lucky to maintain possession because they're very high in the ruck, and they were getting pushed back pretty heartily by Fresno High. It looks like they're getting pushed back again. Fresno High is counter-rucking very effectively.
Yeah, scrum half is
and it looks like they just stole a good, clean ball. Nice counter-ruck.
Scrum half picked it up and is running.
And he's looking for support, but nobody's there.
And there he is again.
And there's
Jonah.
Reset that ball, Jonah. You got to release it, and he's going to be called for it.
Maldonado, Jonah Maldonado.
So in the tackle in rugby, you have to release the ball to maintain continuity of play.
Yeah.
And this time he got caught for it.
So good call by the ref, and Paul here knows what he's talking about. That was a great call. It's going to be their penalty. So they will tap, or they can kick for touch. Looks like he's chosen to kick for touch. He's going to kick it right at us. See how if he makes it out of bounds. And he didn't find touch, so it'll be live ball. Scrum half number 9 from Fresno High makes a counter kick.
And nice counter kick. Nobody in the back.
No one there. It's going to go. He's fine, though. He can go into the try zone and come back out. He's run good. Not sure what he called offsides.
That is an offsides.
Offsides against Fresno High. So what happened there, the kicker was kicked from back behind the 50-yard line, but he had players in front of him on his own team that advanced towards the ball. And in rugby, he must wait for that player to be in front of them, or they must stand still.
So someone's got to put them on, and no one did in that case.
So here's a chance to kick a touch
another
again.
Another kick for and touch. It's going to stand again, Barry.
He missed it again. So here's a good run-up and a kick.
And a nice counter kick.
Again, this time they're all holding still. And now it's a good run outside here, by handled well by Clovis West. In rugby, you can kick it. You can kick it forward, but you can't throw it forward. So well done
and
by both
Clovis
teams
West
here.
Can get this ball out, but unfortunately, they just are inexperienced in the back line, it looks like. They weren't in a very good attacking shape, Barry, and there was a lost opportunity. Number 12 is running the ball very nicely right now.
Yeah, I think the footsteps were heard from one of the Fresno High players as he approached that guy and made him look away a little bit. That could be another try coming up here.
Close.
Oh, looks like it was passed forward, it looks like, or knocked forward. I'm not sure what he called there. It looks like it must have been something. Fresno.
No, I think he did a double movement.
Okay, it's a penalty, though, for Clovis West. Something penalized against Fresno High for that. Let's see if third time's a charm. Nope, still didn't get it out of bounds for the kick and touch. Number 20 again is going, picked up the ball for Fresno High. Let's see where we're going to recycle it. Here it comes again. Number 2. For Fresno High, they're still going. Oh, Clovis West has the ball. Lost it there in the tackle somehow. So Clovis West has got the ball.
It's getting a little chippy.
Yeah. There we go.
And there's a nice kick. He finally got it out of the touch line.
Oh, almost.
So that's going to favor Clovis West a little bit and get them out of their own try zone area.
Undisciplined. That's the word I was thinking. I couldn't think of undisciplined. But
ladies and gentlemen, if you see my partner right now, he was trying to get it out. Maybe I should have gave him a little help. I feel like I'm doing Sonic commercials over here.
Here we go. So we got a line out in favor of Clovis West this time.
Let's
see how we do. They've got the full line out, full 7 players in the line out, it looks like.
This wind's tough for lineouts. Let's see if they can convert on this.
Tough from that angle. We've got about a little over 4 minutes to go. Substitution there by
Nice Fresno throw. High. Nice throw. Unfortunately, it just Clovis West is really attacking the rucks well. I like it. Actually, both teams are, but I've been seeing some really good aggressive play by both teams.
Yeah, definitely here. And I think Clovis West
I'm surprised they're not being called, though, more for not releasing the ball in the tackle. If you're in the grasp of the tackler, as a ball carrier, you must, as you hit the ground, release the ball.
Yeah.
So, like some of the double movement penalties we saw a minute ago, you either have to release it or pass it.
Yeah.
If you don't do either one, then it's a double movement, therefore a penalty.
Still live there. The I would have to say, I think Clovis West is starting to play a little better. They're maintaining a little more possession the last 10 minutes, and thus the score a minute ago. But they're just having a little tough time getting much yardage. But they're playing good rugby, good hard forward running, reset rugby.
Well, Fresno High's a little disorganized, and what Clovis West has been able to do is to pick those balls off the side of the ruck, and there's really no defender there because they're a little tired and they're getting back in defense slowly.
Yeah.
But there's a stolen ball by number 20.
Yeah.
And number 20, who was the victim of having the ball ripped out of his hand, just ripped a ball out of someone else's hand. So
yeah.
Good on him.
Alberto Reyes there is making up for some of his little miscues earlier in the game. So that's the great thing about rugby. You've got, they don't just pull you out. If you make a mistake, you keep playing. And you're out there for the full game. Usually we don't make a lot of subs in rugby. There's a good hard run. That's like a try. That's a try.
A beautiful try.
So high.
Beautiful
scores
effort
again
by the number 6 flanker, who just basically took the ball up straight up the pitch, broke some tackles, kept his legs rolling, and scored a try. That's good old-fashioned rugby, folks.
That was number 6. That was Benny Ramirez, if that was the try scorer. Number 6, if that was him. Great effort on an individual effort there to get that try for Fresno High. So that puts Fresno High up 5 more points. That gives them 22-5 with the conversion to come. See how he does this time. I've got about 2 minutes to go in half before the half. In rugby, there is generally a 5-minute intermission. Sometimes, I think here for video, we're going to do 10. So let's see if the kick was good. I see the flags up by the touch
nice
judges.
Nice kick.
So
well
two
struck.
Two more points. So it's 24. No, sorry, 20. We got it on here. So yeah, 24-5 in favor of Fresno High. Had to work on my math there a little bit. So we got it going. So we got Fresno High to receive the ball after their score. And we've just got about a minute and a half to go, so the referee keeps the actual time on the field. Our clock is a running clock, so he may have stopped it along the way, but we didn't see, except for that one little injury, but or time for injury. Clovis West making a few substitutions. Number 17 going in is Trevor McIntosh.
Well, a nice little scrib kick. It was kind of a heads-up play if that young man would have chose to dive on it instead of kicking it. He might have been able to pick up his own kick and maintain possession.
Penalty here against Clovis West. Looks like a dump tackle, I think is what he's going to call him for. Lifted him up off the ground and dumped the player on the ground.
And he's going to get a yellow card for it for unsafe play.
So he will sit out for, I believe it's 10 minutes and at this level. Kind of like a yellow card in soccer or sin bin.
Yeah,
oh, no,
he's going to hit. That's right. He's going to, it's for all you people out there and anyone who's eating chocolate cookies when mom said no, you're going to do a timeout.
Yeah, timeout. So he's got 30 or 10. Oh, heads up here.
Hey, we almost got nailed by a ball. We almost got in the action here, Barry. Where's my mouthpiece and boots?
And that looks like halftime, so referee has blown the whistle, and it is now halftime with the score 24-5 in favor of Fresno High over Clovis West here on Friday night high school rugby at Roosevelt High School.
Great. It's a good game, and it's been aggressive by both teams. Good to see good old-fashioned rugby being played in right here in Fresno. Now, they say that Fresno is now one of the fastest growing youth rugby areas in the country.
Yeah, oh, it's grown at an explosion. We're done? Okay, we're going to take a break here for halftime. Again, Fresno High 24, Clovis West 5. All right,
and
there
there's the kickoff.
Yep.
For the second half. And Clovis West players immediately hit on that kickoff.
Yeah, they're falling on the ground.
And Fresno High was able to get that ball back. They're setting it for a ruck. The ball's pitched out. And,
nice
oh,
pass.
There it is. Look for that pass. Oh, that was a tough luck. That was a tough deal right there. Little unlucky.
Yeah.
You know, Marquise maybe should have made that pass a little sooner. I don't know. I thought, you know, he did the best he could, but put the ball out a little wide to his wing. His wing probably should have stepped in a little closer in support, but oh, well, that's just the way it goes. But that would have been a beautiful link-up, Barry, if they were to make that thing happen.
Yeah, just a little inexperienced there. You can see the way he made that pass. He didn't turn his shoulder and turn towards to his outside player, make a little better pass, take a hit or something. But that ball popped straight out the other side, I think. The referee's going to restart it. Yeah, unfortunate for Fresno High there, but they're going to reset here. Clovis West is going to re-scrum it here, put the ball in.
Well, I tell you, it was just nice to see some backline play. You know, it just goes to show what we've been saying in the first half, that it's been real tight in the forward pack, and get the ball out a little bit to the backline, and almost caught Clovis West off guard there.
Yeah, yeah, they sure did. Now we've got Clovis West putting the ball in. They've lost it. Stolen by Fresno High.
Nice counter scrum by Fresno High, and we got Jonah running hard. Unfortunately, he didn't really have anyone support to pass to, or he didn't feel like it was a passable ball, so he just ran straight up. But they're able to recycle this thing out again.
Getting out to the backs this time.
And Fresno High must have talked at halftime, because they are getting the ball out to their back line more effectively. And you can see it's working. Unfortunately, Marquise has got to get that ball set on the pitch a little sooner.
Yeah. Do something different there. Make a pass quicker or
and,
go to the ground.
There's number six, at that flanker.
Good run by Fresno High there.
And here's another good run, it looks like, Barry.
It's Benny Ramirez, the number six running. Who we got now? We've got another, held him up right in front of the try line. Let's see how we do here.
You know, Clovis West had some missed tackles there on that run. We teach our kids to go low. If you go high, you might take a ride. And that was the case there.
So I think the referee stopped the play there because he was indicating that it was close to the goalpost there, and they don't have the greatest padding on that goalpost. So he said if it was going to end up there, they're going to move it off a little bit. So we're going to re-scrum here. Looks like probably Fresno High put in for the scrum. And they're about 5 meters out. So move away from that goalpost a little bit. Got the Fresno High backs here ready to go. They're spread out a little more.
Well, they're in a good, deep attacking shape. And, they're going to go to the weak side. See if they can catch Clovis West offside. They got a nice little offload to Jonah, and he's in for the try. So it was
another try by
well-executed play to the weak side of the pitch. And that was good on Patty Myers there.
That was Jonah Maldonado scoring that try for Fresno High School.
So I'm giving a little props to Patty Myers, the head coach for the Fresno High Rugby Club, for drawing up a little weak side play there.
Formerly
the head coach of the Fresno Men's Club.
Yeah, Patty coached the men's club back in about 99 and 2000, I think, when we went to the Final Four for the first time in 15s rugby, Fresno Rugby Club in 1999, all the way back to Chicago, Illinois. We ended up third in the nation that year.
Some good rugby in those days.
Definitely.
I played with the club during that time frame, but was kept out with a torn ACL, unfortunately.
Yeah, that happens now and then, but especially when you play as hard as you did there, Mr. Pitt. We called Paul Pitt when he was playing rugby, although we didn't give him that nickname, but it fit him when he played rugby, that's for sure. There's a good-looking kick there, and it was good.
Yeah, so we've well got struck. He sounds like points. It looks like he's found his groove there, Barry.
Yeah, that was nice. So we got a score now of 31-5 in favor of Fresno High.
Nice kick.
Oops. So Clovis West will kick off again to Fresno High. You can see the. I think we're just seeing a difference of two things, kind of. Of what's making the difference to the game is the experience level and size of the players. So Fresno High's got a few good-sized players and just a little bit more experience. Again, for Clovis West, I think will be a strong team going forward. They've got some good coaches again. Just you know, getting organized on the campus to recruit players out is the key, and it's happening in all the Clovis schools and will continue to happen. I think for Clovis West, so a little nice kick for. Kickoff there, it went out of bounds just after bouncing on the inside of the touch line. So that is fine. That's a good kickoff. It'll go to Fresno High.
And, you know, you know, the inability or the inactivity of Fresno High there to catch that ball and misjudge that will drive a coach crazy. You really want your kids to catch that ball in flight. You never let it hit the pitch. And in that case, that time Fresno High did, and, you know, it cost them some valuable grass.
Yeah, definitely. You never want to see that ball not be caught on a kickoff. So there we have a throw-in that was what we call not straight. So instead of going straight down the middle of the tunnel, it was thrown a little bit more towards the side to the advantage of Fresno High, which is not allowed. So the referee said, we're going to scrum it down right here on the 15-meter line in from the try line, and it'll go to Clovis West. Actually, Clovis West had the option of taking a line out themselves or going to a scrum, and they chose to scrum. So it'll be Clovis West scrum put in, as we say. Again, oh, they lost it again. So in the scrum there, the what they call the hooker or the hook has the ability to sometimes get the ball from the other team, and they did it just then. Good run by their.
Yeah, and it looked like the ball was knocked forward on the pass out to the back line, but it looked like it must have went backwards.
Could've
and
been.
We got a nice little strong run.
It's number 20
and
again.
If number 20 can take it all away. He's got support,
yep.
But he just couldn't get it off, and I think the support was a little late getting to him.
There was Alberto Reyes with a good run again.
Nice
he's had a few
run,
good
Alberto.
Runs. Yep. Oh, I don't know if he got that knocked on or not. I guess not.
Must have bounced on the pitch before it hit his hands. And
yeah, it's hard to call from here.
Yeah.
Referee was right there, so there's another
Let's
line.
See, there's number six again.
Good
and
run.
This kid run hard.
Oh,
and he just threw that. That was a hot potato pass.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, fortunately, it lucked out, and they were able to maintain possession, but that was a terrible pass. Young man's got to look that pass in and make a sure-handed pass to his support player.
So it looked like Clovis West, they stole the ball there, reached over and grabbed it. And they're going to try to make some moves here and gain some ground. Penalty against Fresno High for a high tackle.
Yeah.
So they'll back up.
Can't go above the shoulders in contact.
Good.
The ref sees it, he's going to call it.
Good quick playing by the scrum half or the fly half for Clovis West. That's Kyle Hancock. He's going to make a kick at touch here, and he does.
And Barry, I don't think he messed around this time. He didn't care about getting distance. He just wanted to get it out of bounds on the touchline. He kicked it right towards us.
Yeah, he's not going to go for distance anymore.
Yeah, that's right.
It's a good play. It'll be Clovis West throw in. It was a penalty, so when it's your penalty and you kick it out of bounds, you regain possession as long as it did go out of bounds. He could have tapped it and ran with it, but they chose to kick for touch and try to gain some ground. Didn't gain a lot of ground, but that's all right. It's their ball. It's going to be their throw, and he's got to throw it straight down that tunnel. And they've got a play called, so we don't know who's going to jump to get it, but went over the top.
And
landed in his hands, but it went straight down.
I think Clovis West players are a little surprised. Good on him to maintain possession. If he would have been switched on a little more, he might have been able to turn up the pitch for some extra meters.
Yeah, but I think a little surprise to Samuel Madden there that got that ball out of the throw-in.
Like, you know, both teams except, I think Fresno High's done a better job of running straight up the pitch, but Clovis West seems to be running sideways a little too much, and it has not netted them a lot of meters on the pitch.
Yeah, unfortunately, they just don't have the physical strength, as I say that, to run through the Fresno High guys, and there's a good run by the Clovis West player. A little chit-chat going on from Fresno High there. So it looked like the referee penalized for a high tackle or a dangerous tackle.
You know,
maybe.
He lifted him off the pitch, and you know, you got to be responsible for how you, if you lift a player off the pitch, you're responsible for how he gets back on the pitch. And the refs thought that was a little dangerous play, and he's going to call it.
Yeah, you can make some great hits in rugby, but you can't lift a player and slam him down into the ground. That's considered a dangerous or a tilt tackle because it could cause neck injuries and. So you have to bring him back safely to the ground. But you can make a great hard tackle if you don't leave your feet and don't let him leave his feet. So it's that's how you make the good tackles and good hard tackles in rugby. So Clovis West kicked for their penalty, and they've reached touch, and it will be a line out just about at the 50-yard meter, the center of the field here. Clovis West throw in. We got a good view of it from our vantage point here. We can see you're straight down the tunnel, as they call it. Supposed to be 1 meter in between that tunnel. It was a good throw, but stolen by Fresno High off the Looks like a knock on by Clovis West on that throw in, and it went right to the Fresno High player, though, although I think he could have played advantage on that and let them keep going. But sometimes the referee makes that call quickly, and it's not easy out there. I know I've done it a few times and tried, and it's a thankless job, trust me.
It's not easy to call a rugby match.
Yeah.
But you're speaking the advantage play. We always tell our kids, play to the whistle.
Yeah, you bet.
And because you just never know until that whistle blows, play is still going. And
guys, again, I can see
the ball's won, but Clovis West is having a hard time getting it out. And let's see if Clovis West, they're doing a decent job here recycling this ball, getting over the advantage line. See if they can do it again. Let's see, this is sort of an unopportune kick here for Clovis West, though.
Fly half chose to kick it, didn't get much distance, and it went
out of bounds. Well, that's the downside of being disorganized in the back line. The ball's getting out to the back, so disorganized, really don't have nowhere to go, and they're not in a very good attacking shape, and so you just kick it away, try to get something, and it's a little unfortunate. I think it goes back to what you were talking about earlier about the issues of experience.
Yeah. Yeah, and they're showing it a little bit here, but they're still playing good. They're playing, holding their own, and we're a little more 10 minutes into this half, and they haven't only got one score, so that's shows that they're holding in there, holding it up. Pick and go by
there was a knock on by the Fresno High team, but there's an advantage carried out to Clovis West, and if they can maintain this ball. During advantage play, they'll be okay, and if not, it'll be a scrum to them either way, so they're in good shape.
Yep, pass
it up. See if they can do something here.
Yep, the backs are losing a little bit of ground here. Good tackling by Fresno High, good defense. Let's see what happens here. They got a couple more backs out here if they can get it out to them.
Well, that pick and drive seems to be working a little bit. Like to see a little more of those Clovis West players get in there in that ruck and help drive that man forward, but we'll see what. See what we get here. It looks like we're going to get a scrum down to Clovis West.
Yep. It'll knock on again by Fresno High. Well, the lights are coming on. They got them coming on early, which is great. So we got a few games to go tonight. We got two more games to go tonight.
So we are officially Friday Night Lights.
There we go. Oh, pit.
Okay, it's nice. Oh unfortunately, number nine's got to hold on to that ball a little tighter than that. And he just got, someone stole his donuts.
I'm not sure what that means, but we'll leave it at that. Penalty against
I don't know, but
Fresno
if someone steals my donut, I'm not going to be happy.
Nice run
here by Clovis West.
Nice straight arm. For a little guy, that guy's pretty tough, I tell you what.
Yeah, I tell you what, it was a nice run. And, it just...
Kyle
Unfortunately, he was sort of isolated. He didn't have anyone there to support him.
Kyle Hancock.
I like this number one. This big boy is a load, and he can run hard.
Yeah, that's Alexander.
Oh, but he
Burnaby.
Lost the ball.
Oh, did he? Held up the good straight-up tackle there by Clovis West. They're going to maybe push him out of bounds. Ball still alive. Clovis West got the ball back there. They're trying to reset it.
Well, that's just an unfortunate. The Clovis West forwards are so too undisciplined. The ball gets won, and someone wants to pass out of the back line. All the forwards are in the way.
Again, trying to steal the ball there from
that should have been diving
Fresno
over the ruck there. They got away with one, Fresno High did.
Trying to get the ball out of that ruck.
So there's a ball won. Yep. Immediately met by number nine.
Yeah, for Fresno High. Good tackling, good defense for Fresno High. Looks like they've stolen the ball.
They
picked
sure
it
did.
Good offensive, defensive play there by the Clovis West player, but he went over the ball, I think. Held on to, so it should be a penalty against Fresno High for not releasing the ball and hanging onto it in the tackle. And when you do get tackled, like Paul was saying earlier, you got to release that ball and put it back, but held onto it too long there.
So this has been a spirited match. Both sides going at it pretty hard, and that's what rugby's about. The other thing about it, this is one of the things I've always loved about it, is the camaraderie that's in the game.
Yep.
And the principles that are intact to rugby is something that's very attractive to me. You know, these young men, after the match and written in the laws of the game, will sit down and have a meal together. The home team will host the visiting team to a meal, and they will talk about, you know, the match, and they'll show respect to one another and show respect to their competitors. And it's just something that's part of the game that I love and respect. And I think it's very good for these young men to carry on that tradition.
Yeah, definitely. Traditional part of the game is the aftermatch socializing, and that's been going on for as long as rugby's been around. I think since 1924 or 1823 or 24 is when rugby was introduced. So it's one of the oldest sports in the world. Originated in Rugby, England, with William Webb Ellis. So we had a 22 drop out there. The ball went all the way back outside of the out of the side of the try zone, outside the back. So Fresno High
sort of a lost counterattack opportunity. Clovis West has got playing a little selfishly, and maybe that's their inexperience. But number 14 could have offloaded that ball out to a couple support players on the edge, and maybe got a little more flow there offensively.
Yeah, you can see that Clovis West is doing just mostly a lot of pick and goes, and with their size, they're not making a lot of gaining a lot of ground. Whereas if they, get some of their players to get a little bit of a run, maybe from about 5 meters back, which I think they'll probably be working on this week at practice, they will be a little more effective. They're trying to do it. They got it set up, but they're just not quite getting there yet. Here comes that elusive fly half number 10. That's Kyle Hancock.
Boy, that young man's playing tough, isn't he?
He is.
All playing tough. You know what? There's not a player on the pitch right now that's got their boots and mouthpiece in that are not playing tough. You get on a rugby pitch and you got my respect, Barry.
Well, I tell you, I know, Pitt, you were a wrestler, and I tell you, rugby is a lot like wrestling. A lot of times when you're in those tackles and you're trying to wrestle for that ball, you're expelling a lot of energy. That's for
sure. That's right. It's very relentless pressure.
You bet. There's a good run down the sideline. Oh, little kick
nice
ahead.
Little squib kick, and it looks like there may be, should have been a penalty for, and it looks like the referee did catch it. You cannot hit the man. That's a defenseless player, and it's going to be called as it should be.
Yeah, he did. He made a nice little kick ahead, and I think the ball even went right into the touch zone. And
if you like hits, it was a nice one, but it was not legal.
It was more of a... not a violent, but it just shoved him afterwards, and he wasn't expecting it. So put him out on his hind end there a little bit, but they're going to keep.
Oh, nice run here. Boy, it was a nice right little dummy there. And well, that we call that catching fish with no bait. Someone took a bite, and there was nothing there, right?
Yeah.
That was a nice dummy for a try.
That was our Alberto, I think, Reyes again. Yeah. He scored a couple of times, I think, tonight.
That's right.
But nice hard run right through the defense there of Clovis West, unfortunately. But so we got another kick at conversion kick here. So with about 15 minutes to go.
Well, I'll tell you what, for a early April night, it's a good night for rugby right here.
Oh yeah, it's great. No. Thought there might be some chance of rain. Some of those clouds looked like they were a little dark, but they've all cleared away. We've got a bright, sunny sunset coming up here. There's another good kick for two more points for Fresno High.
All the years we played together, it was always Saturday afternoons, right, Barry?
Yeah, some of the club level rugby and some of the college level rugby, usually anything higher than high school tends to play on Saturday afternoons, mornings.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's where we...
Would have been nice to get under the lights, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Would
be great.
Have been nice to do that.
Yeah, no, we didn't play too many games at night, but a lot of Saturdays of playing rugby are a lot of fun. It's a great sport. A lot of good friends from rugby. Here we got a little kick and
little,
knock on.
A little unlucky by the
again,
by
there's
the prop.
Good play by Clovis
on.
West.
And good on Clovis West. Remember what we talked about earlier? There was advantage play, and Clovis West was switched on, and they kept playing, and Fresno High didn't. And they're going to get the ball back because it was advantage play.
Yeah, you're right. Play to the whistle, exactly. The guy knocked it on, the player there, and he just kind of gave up and left it. And then Clovis West smartly grabbed the ball and took off running. Now it's a Clovis West put in. And again, it looks like they've lost it in the scrum. Going to Fresno High side. passed out to their back here.
You mentioned it earlier, and you said some of the teams were getting a little too high in the scrums, and you can see that, that Clovis West has been real high and losing their leverage in the scrum, and Fresno High has been able to steal Clovis West put-ins.
Yeah, definitely probably a weight advantage there a little bit, too. They can push them off the ball probably easier than most. Fresno High's got some good-sized players out there.
For some of you wide-eyed people at home watching this match right now, you can see that these kids are really going at it tough. When we talk about being too high, that means you're losing your leverage. And in rugby, leverage is everything.
Yep, quick little throw into the front player there at the line out for Clovis West, and took off and started running with it.
Ball stuck in there, and you know, Clovis West is, there's been a few times there the ball's won, and all they have to do is get in there and take it out, and it's just been a little slow to react, but they're still in pretty good shape here. Let's see if they can get something put together.
Yep, they've got the ball again.
Yeah.
They're gonna put it in. Just kind of get it to their side and win it. They got their backs ready to go. Unfortunately, they've lost it again. The referee is gonna restart it. I think he tried to tell the players to stay where they were on the backs, but they moved up and he decided to restart it here. So a little inadvertent whistle there, I believe.
So the ball's put in.
There we go.
Clovis West might be able to get this ball, but they're being pushed back.
Yeah, driving
a little
over
unsafe there.
He's given a penalty to Clovis West, surprisingly. I'm not sure why, but nice
pass little
out.
Offload
that
there.
Should be a try there.
And
there's
that was
a
beautiful, beautiful try.
Yeah,
good heads up, tap and go by number 10. He's had a really good match tonight. Really impressed with this young man.
Yeah,
and a beautiful, unselfish offload to his eight man.
Yeah, great job. The score try was that's Eric Blickbarg for Clovis West.
Well, I will tell you, rugby is the ultimate team sport. And everybody gets a chance to roam the ball, but everyone also has a chance to offload the ball and support their teammate in all phases of the game. And right there was just one indication of unselfish play by number 10.
Yeah, definitely. I think one of the great things about rugby, especially for what we call forwards in the game, is, you know, every player on the field has the same opportunity to touch the ball, to play the ball, to run the ball. Whereas in football, sometimes those big guys, they don't see the ball very often. They might catch a fumble here and there.
Right.
But boy, rugby out here, it's great to have those big guys run it sometimes, and just it's a great. Great game for everybody getting to play.
Well, it was definitely one of the things I loved about it. Let's see if number 10 can make this kick. It's a little windy.
Oh.
And just a little unlucky there.
So we've got
a tough deal.
38-10 in favor of Fresno High as we go into with about 11 minutes to go.
So that's right, everyone gets a chance to run. Even guys like me that are slower than a garden snail can run with the ball, Barry.
Yeah. But you know what, we like it. Being a back again, we like those big guys running that ball because we don't have to run it all the time. And a little rivalry usually between backs and forwards in rugby, but that's all right.
Yeah, that's right.
At the end of the game, we're all one team, and we're always one team. And you always shake hands with everybody afterwards and leave it all on the field, as they say. That kick probably didn't go 10 meters. I think it went straight out, but it's up to the referee. He's going to say they're going to play
really
it.
Not really seeing 10-meter markings.
Yeah, they
so
missed.
He's really going to have to eyeball that thing and
they missed
see
those.
What he calls here. For. He's going to give a line out to Clovis West.
I know that we appreciate the Roosevelt High School staff that helped set up this field. I know they're busy. They had a softball games and a few other things to set up for and track meets, I think, today. But they took time this morning to set up this rugby field.
And it is beautiful. This pitch is beautiful.
Yeah, it's a nice grass, nice facility. The rain that we've had a little bit kind of softens things up. Good run there by number 6 from Fresno High.
Yeah, I like the way that kid runs. He runs at pace, and he attacks the advantage line with a lot of pace on those runs, and he's been successful because of it.
Yep, that's Benny Ramirez.
And,
nice pass out to the fly half,
little
stolen by... Kind of inadvertent pass by Fresno High. Clovis West got his hands on it. Looks like Fresno High may retain the ball here. A ruck in rugby is when the ball goes to the ground. A maul in rugby is when the player stays on his feet and is kind of held up with players. Well, so many different.
Let's see if he can stay in.
That was a bit of a maul there that I think the touch judge on the sideline said the player
touched. Yeah, it looked like he was going to try to stay in, but I guess they drug him out. So it's going to be a line out to Clovis West.
So again, the ball's got to go straight down the tunnel, as they say. Looks like it bounced off of
and it's
going to
be
West
a
right
lucky
Fresno
bounce
High
for Fresno High. Very unlucky for Clovis West, and it results in a try and a good heads-up play by the by number nine.
Yeah, so that was a throw-in. It looked like it bounced off of a hand or shoulder of the Clovis West player, and right into the hands of Fresno High and scored.
And ladies and gentlemen, if you're watching that, that was not an intended throw-in by Clovis West. And just a lucky play for Fresno High, but the Fresno High player was switched on, and he was a benefactor of a good, clean ball in his hands and a scamper into the try zone.
Yep, so we've got a kick here again by number 22 from Fresno High. He's been pretty successful the last couple of kicks. Let's see how he does here. Again, these are not regulation rugby goalposts that you're looking at. Those look like soccer goals with some poles taped, wired up to the top of them. Again, we're just kind of making do
well
here.
Well struck again, Barry.
Yeah, great kick there.
So
buddy.
22 has found his groove on his kicks.
So we're looking at 45 to 10 in favor of Fresno High. As I was saying, these are soccer goals that they've converted to make some rugby goals. Since rugby's so new here, we don't have any permanent rugby fields really in Fresno. We've got a few parks that we're working with the city of Fresno with, and we appreciate all their help and time that they give to rugby. But we're growing quickly, and we're gonna have more of those in the future here, so.
Here so we go. Fresno High's really kind of padded their lead here, and looks like they're breaking out just a little more. They're obviously been the little more effective than Clovis West.
Yeah, I think another call here for obstruction. The Fresno High player ran behind one of his own players.
Which is illegal.
Yeah, so it's a penalty here. It's kind of like a block, like Paul was saying earlier in the match, but just an accidental running behind the player and blocking.
And in rugby, whether it's accident or not, it doesn't make a difference. A lot of times, and you've heard the term during this broadcast, to run straight up the pitch. A lot of times when kids do not run straight up the pitch, they run sideways is when they get called for obstruction.
Yeah, that's one of the hardest things to coach some of these high school players because of maybe their football background or a soccer background where you're running many, many directions to avoid a player because you're the only guy that's going to carry that ball. But in rugby, you can pass it off to someone else. Good pick up and run here by number eight. Not sure what,
They weren't 10. They didn't retreat 10 on the original penalty.
Yep, Clovis West is good at making that quick, what they call a quick tap and go.
Yes, you're absolutely right. They've been effective with that.
They don't have to wait for the other team to get back. So if they go.
Big number eight's going to try to run that ball in, see if Clovis West can recycle this ball. Very close to a try line. They're going to pick and go again. He's resetting the ball. They're getting been able to get over the advantage line. Let's see if they can recycle it back through again here, Barry.
Hopefully they can hang on to it and get it going here. They've got their backs out there, but they're a little thin and far between there. They should be a little closer together. Play's still going on.
Well, if
looks like Fresno High
got
the ball.
They lost the ball.
Nice
catch by number 11, but he's all by himself.
Yeah,
well, we say he's isolated. He's out on an island. Give him a can of tuna.
So we've got them still battling. They've got the ball still in possession, resetting it to their side. Just a little disorganized on Clovis West, but it's all right. They're tired. They're walking. Like Fresno High just walked up and stole that ball right out of his hands, I think. Whistle against.
Well, it looks like there
Fresno
was a knock
High.
Forward. Maybe was it number nine broke through.
Yeah.
He had a nice break.
Yeah, I think he might have knocked it on there, and the referee saw that, and that was hard.
Good defensive play. Just got a little unlucky.
So it'll be Clovis West put in here. We've got about 5 minutes to play. 45-10 in favor of Fresno High. Whistle, I think they moved too far off the mark. There's a mark given at a scrum, and then high school rugby, the mark, they cannot move more than 1 meter in either direction. So that may have happened there. The referee's given a little talking to.
So we got two more matches here at Roosevelt High School tonight. Got Dan Wilson sitting next to the broadcast table here. He's head referee of the association. We couldn't do what we do out here without him leading the pack. We're real grateful for that. It was a good job.
We'll say lots of nice things about Dan right now, but the people on the sidelines will be saying other things during the game. But,
you know, it's just a tough,
that's
tough place to be as a referee, ladies and gentlemen. Tough place to be, but he does a hell of a job.
He does.
So we have two other matches tonight, right, Barry?
Yeah, we do. We've got Clovis playing Bullard at 7 o'clock, and Buchanan's going to play Roosevelt at 8:30. So,
oh, that should be a good match, that Roosevelt-Buchanan game. Roosevelt's really come on, and Buchanan's a really good team and still trying to secure their second seed position in the league at this point.
Yeah, Clovis and Bullard will be televised. Here we got a great big run by number 8 from Clovis West. He should be able to score.
The kid was rumbling up the pitch.
Held up or not, is he on the line? Oh, stolen by Fresno High, but the whistle's blown. Looks like a penalty against Fresno High. Not sure what the call is.
Clovis West is going to be a benefactor of this.
Quick.
And number 8 has got a little bit of wheels.
Definitely, that was a great run by Eric Gilkbarg from Clovis West. That was about a 40-meter run.
Let's see if we can punch this in. You got Fresno High lined up on that try zone line, and as soon as Clovis West takes off, they're going to try to put the wood to them. See if they can keep them out.
Yeah, they ought.
Number 10 maybe should offload it to one of his bigger players, but he decided to pick it up and go himself.
Yeah, they got
a little white line fever here.
They got some room this side of the this way. There's a
yeah, there's that
guy.
Number 1. Was that number 1?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, he's going to get that ball held up. It'd be wise to get the ball out.
It's Alexander Burnaby.
Well, I just don't think Clovis West has been effective in the back line, so they're probably going to just they're probably smart to just keep it in with their forwards and try to punch that over.
Yeah, I think so. Still there. Ball still there. The back's
so that finally does come out.
You can see the number 12 out here saying, give me the ball, give me the ball.
Just too shallow in the back line. So they're being hit immediately by the defensive back line because their backs are just too far up close to the advantage line. Clovis West backs are and just not very good attacking shape.
They're driving. They're maintaining the possession, though. Let's see what happens here. They needed somebody to get in there and dig it out. I think their scrum half is probably sucked into the tackle. The whistle's been blown. It's going to be a scrum. Two, not sure who yet. Looks like Clovis West again. Not sure what the call was, why it was given back to Clovis West. Usually if the ball is carried in and it's not used, the opposite team will receive the ball. They did not take the ball into the scrum, but looks like Clovis West is going to maintain possession here. They haven't had much luck on their scrums tonight, but we'll see how it goes here if they get it in quickly. That didn't go as well as he wanted. Looked like it bounced off the prop's foot.
And Fresno is going to attack here.
Yeah, good tackle.
Met immediately.
13.
And, outside. Nice run. Good tackle, though. You know, Clovis, both teams have been tackling pretty good tonight. Really impressed with the tackling of it in this match.
Yep.
Good double leg tackle there.
Oh, good breakthrough.
Oh, nice little break here, and that's what happens when you attack the advantage line at pace, get that ball in hand.
Looks like Benny Ramirez again making quite a few good breaks tonight for Fresno High. Lost the ball again, though. I don't know if that was Benny that lost it, but good play there by the Clovis West player there, doing some straight arms and fending off some players there.
Well, we got a really good match coming up after this one, the Bullard-Clovis High match, and not to jinx Bullard, but they're undefeated at this point, and let's see if they can keep that streak alive. I know Clovis is going to want to try to change that streak, and it's going to be a spirited match.
Yeah,
and
looks like that's
speaking
the end
of matches,
the game.
That's the end of this match.
So a great game. Fresno High comes out on top, 45-10 against Clovis West in our first match. All right, so that's the end of this match. Thank you, and we will see you in the next game. Thanks, Paul for helping out here, buddy.
Been great. Glad
appreciate
to be here.
You bet. Thanks.